I'm Sandra, this is Jessie.
My name's Jessie.
Well, we had a really great session at Dutch Design Week yesterday. Jessie was hosting. What do you think?
Yeah, I enjoyed it very much. I think we had over 35 people joining us at one moment in time, and we heard some inspiring lightning talks. We had excellent keynote speakers. So it was really great to hear all your insights and experiences on the health challenges.
Today, we're going to switch subject matters and we are going to talk about circular design. Now, I know circular doesn't resonate so much in Canada as it did in the Netherlands, but we hope to give you more insights by introducing some circular designers and have great discussion. So, shall we go?
Yeah, let's go.
Object Density, I'm Kim Stanek.
I'm Nicola Charlesworth.
And this is our project, The Good Egg. So we designed these egg cups as a stacking pair. They both weigh almost the same as a small egg. And so with this we were trying to create the metaphor of once you use these and buy these and live with these, you can remove an egg's worth of plastic from your environment. We've designed them to be made out of polypropylene, number 5 plastic, and that can be endlessly recycled without any degradation or loss of quality. So these can be popped in the recycling, shredded down and remade into a great new product.
So these were designed and made using the precious plastic world of knowledge. So that's how we kind of started. Precious Plastic used to be in Eindhoven, so we went to see them, got some contacts through that and learned more about it. And we just thought it was a really great way to start at quite a low individual level, accessible way to start taking part and I guess account for all the plastic waste in a small way.
Academy, and this is one of my graduation projects, Beach Bloomers. I made baskets from waste from fishing industries, and they are basically made from nets and ropes that are left behind in the ocean. The project started a year ago when I was experimenting with this material. I found it by accident, so I was thinking where do we have an abundance of this material, and I wanted to use that because as I apply my technique it shrinks a lot, so by using this technique I can really use a lot of waste to make objects. When I decided to work with waste, I was expecting a lot of brown and black colors, not colorful things, but I was surprised to see that the waste is really colorful, so that was actually just a coincidence, and I did it like that.
South Korea, and I'm a conceptual and material designer based in Netherlands. And for my graduation project, I created a sustainable and contemporary material called Okragella. So by using only those 4 natural ingredients, so ochre, gelatin, glycerin, and water. And for now, I'm keeping on the research about how to apply my material into the product. And these samples are an extra version of the Okragella and called Plastic Gella, and I put the recycled plastic additionally.